last meeting between the two countries in the home tournament has its fascinations, not least that it pits everyone's choice as footballer of the year, Ian Rush, 44 goals this season for club and country, against the latest recipient of an England cap, Mark Wright, the 20th to be so rewarded in the two seasons of Bobby Robson's stewardship. It's a big evening too for two Welshmen who win their first caps, David Phillips of Plymouth Argyle and Mark Hughes of Manchester United. And a check on the Welsh lineup confirms the changing face of Mike England's side, with Mickey Thomas just the old man of the party at 29 in a contest there with Joey Jones. But while an historic contest comes to an end, the long-running farce called trying to pick an England team continues. Bobby Robson lost another player through injury this morning when Trevor Francis cried off, so that means that Paul Walsh plays instead of being with the under-21 team in Italy. And he's playing in a side which really bears little resemblance from the one that Robson would like to have fielded. David Phillips of Plymouth Argyle. And Mark Hughes of Manchester United. Bobby Robson's 18th game in charge of England. And Mike England is back where he started 4 years ago. This is his 32nd game in charge of Wales. The referee from Glasgow is David Syme. Well, that opening match for Mike England produced a 4-1 victory for the Welshmen, and there is a certain feeling amongst the Welsh players that they want to end this tournament in style this evening. England attacking the goal to the right. Here's Ray Wilkins, the captain. Nice little touch. And here's Walsh. Kennedy, about whom there were doubts because of a tummy bug. And the free kick has been given. Kennedy moving into attack, winning his second cap. Beaten out away by Hopkins, playing in the centre of the Welsh defence. To Hopkins, playing alongside Kevin Radcliffe. Phillips. First touch for Mark Wright. There's nice control. Lee, Mike Duxbury, really pleasant evening. And Wright getting into trouble, Hughes. Final shot from Robbie James, but the whole thing the result of slight moment of doubt from the new man, Mark Wright. Lost control of it, and the final shot was also lacking in control. Is the Everton captain, Kevin Radcliffe, and the Welsh captain as well. Hughes, seeing a lot of the ball early, which will please him, and his partnership with Rush will be absolutely crucial in the long term and perhaps in the short term for Wales. Here's Joey Jones to his little man in front of him, Mickey Thomas. Thomas in good nick, having just been promoted with Wales and indeed scored last Saturday against Leeds United. Two of them 29 years old. Jones watching. Lee. Walsh. Woodcock makes the run ahead of Lee now. Just keeps onside. Good to see Armstrong well forward. Woodcock trying to lose his marker. Ray Wilkins. Out by Hopkins. Not too cleanly. Duxbury. Kennedy. Every England player was moving the other way. Neville Southall, it's his 13th cap this evening. Comfortable for Wright. Phillips. First test for Wright in terms of rush. And the bounce favouring the England and Southampton player, who was indeed pushed a little bit. And it should be said that Wright played well against Rush in the league meeting between Southampton and Liverpool that we saw live on Match of the Day. Jones, slightly uncomfortable header. Woodcock. Three England players left for the penalty spot. Here's Duxbury, square is Wilkins. And Wilkins now going on, but the forward ball from Duxbury, his colleague at Manchester United, was too strong. Hughes. Woodcock. Kennedy's move forward. Pass slightly telegraphed. It forced Kennedy to be a bit quick, but he was quick then to regain possession. Gordon Davis doing the backtracking. Playing in midfield this evening. All the players on the right side for Wales do like to go forward, because Phillips, the fullback and the new cap, normally plays in midfield for his club. That was well held by Hopkins and needed to be. Right. Phillips. Gordon Davis, two Davises on the side, Alan Davis of Manchester United. Here he is. Alvin Martin back in the side after the car crash that put him out for two internationals. Hopkins. Three up for Wales, the third one being Thomas. Now watched by Wright. Alan Davis, pressurised by Walsh. Jerry Jones thinks about going forward on the near side as we look, and is now available. Thomas and Duxbury together. Ratcliffe, Jones, Thomas. Maybe Jones didn't go forward. Suspiciously like the use of the forearm, but no appeals. Certainly struck Duxbury. Alan Davis has gone to take the corner. Jerry Jones is on the near post. Rush is further back. And it's coming to neither. Oh, it goes to Rush, and a brilliant save by Shilton. Really clutched that out of the air when Rush should not have had the opportunity for the shot, but the ball was allowed to reach him and he struck it very, very cleanly indeed. See how the ball from the corner goes goes far further across the area than it had any right. Two players left it to each other, and it really was a good stop. Neville Southall, spectator so far. Ratcliffe. England back four yet to settle as a unit, which is hardly surprising. Curiously, that part of the team might well be exactly what was wanted when Bobby Robson picked his squad. Certainly wanted to give a game to Wright, he said so very early. And I think he would also have played Martin. And he wanted to give another game to Kennedy. Free kick to Wales for the foot up. To England for the foot up, I should say. Kennedy. Wilkins. Woodcock. Lee in the middle. So is Walsh. Wilkins. Duxbury. Rush who came back. Now Gregory. It's useful. It was good play by Alan Davis and not such a good finish by Mike Duxbury. But Armstrong very nearly found his way through then. And it was Alan Davis who came back to mark him. Just over 10 minutes of this last meeting between Wales and England in the home international tournament, for the time being at least. 10 minutes have elapsed and no score has been seen. Wilkins, Wright. Hopkins, Martin. A bit bunch for England, but here's Walsh. Southall there first very easily. A little ironic that Bobby Robson desperately wanted to try a permutation with a winger for a few games, and in the end he didn't have one in his squad who was fit. It's a bit short. Ratcliffe. Gregory. Kick given against Walsh. All three of the new caps on the field, 20 years old. Here's one of them, Phillips. No real width. Typical piece of chasing from Jerry Jones, and it might succeed. Yeah, he was a bit unlucky. It's really only the corner flag that denied him. Sammy Lee was too aware of the galloping Welshman. Up for England, four in midfield, the two up, Woodcock and Walsh. Quite a clear push by Ratcliffe. The referee took no action. Hopkins. Gordon Davis, rush, back again to Davis, three waiting. Goal kick Fulham led, might have made a little bit more of that. Certainly found some space on that side. Gordon Davis making the run forward. Space behind, filled by Phillips. Gregory, Armstrong. Two men up front, a bit isolated for a minute. Well held by Woodcock, which is his main job. An England breakout like that. And looking now for the return. Wilkins thinking about the shot, and suddenly there appeared Robbie James. Hopkins. It's the 18th meeting between these two countries here. England have won 11 times and Wales twice. Both the victories by good scores. 5-3 way back in 1882 and 4-1 in May 1980. Woodcock, Lee, Wilkins, Right, Kennedy. Kennedy had in fact moved forward, had to come back for that one. Walsh and Gregory, Phillips in the way, but that's a corner. Acknowledgement from Gregory, and up comes Mark Wright. Wilkins will take. And England have Walsh just short of the near post. Wright going all the way. 8 is Gregory. And 10 Woodcock just to the right. Martin coming late. Out by Hughes. Lee. Didn't get enough height on it, looking for Wilkins. Kennedy. Walsh. Thomas. Two men of roughly the same stature. There's Alan Davis. Rush on the right. And right with him. And they are together again. Right doing the marking job. He's liking the free kick given. Hopkins is up. Jerry Jones is up. Hughes! Oh, and how well directed. And this young man has a fine goal scoring record at club level in the few games he's played for Manchester United. And he marks his debut at full level for Wales with really a finely directed header from the free kick. They had Jones forward, Hopkins forward. But look how neatly the ball was placed. And really nobody got near him with a challenge. So 17 minutes gone and Wales have the lead. Really nicely taken goal, but one about which England won't be too happy because there was no challenge made on the Manchester United player. It's been a problem for Wales scoring enough goals, and this young man has been brought in to help Rush do just that. Really, Wales would have made the last World Cup finals and the European Championship finals to come this year if they could have had more firepower up front. Ian Rush has been somewhat isolated in that role. Now it would seem he may well have found a partner of some physique, which is important. Met by Wright. Martin and Hughes. Oh, well claimed. Pretty typical Peter Shilton expression. Free kick has been given. There's his flag up very early. In total, of which Wales have won 13 only. Right. And they've made the better start in this one. Not well away. James. Kennedy and Gordon Davis. Charge in the back by Gordon Davis. Hopkins and Walsh. Kennedy. Woodcock. Time for Jerry Jones to watch the bounce with care. Did well then, but I think he was pushed a bit. The Chelsea lad having fun. On the ground where he started too, Jerry Jones. And to where he returned after going for several successful years at Liverpool. Martin. Kennedy. Jones nearly got decapitated for his pains then. Armstrong. Lee. Ratcliffe. Trying to turn Hopkins, does so successfully. Not a bad try either. And I think Hopkins might feel that he was pushed a bit. Right. Walsh. Gregory. He's seeing a lot of the ball, as he did in France, and as indeed he did against Northern Ireland at Wembley. Halfway through the first half, and Wales leading by a goal to nothing, and deserving that lead. Example of players not playing with each other. Gregory and Armstrong, both beaten by the bounce. Lee. Woodcock. Woodcock. And Davis often getting into a good defending position just in front of the back players. James. Gordon Davis. Corner kick given in Welsh favour. No, it's not. It's the throw. Phillips thought it was a free kick and led me into that mistake as well. Phillips. Straight to Armstrong. Welsh having real problems at that end. Woodcock in that corner, rather. Woodcock offside. Lee. And the referee has stopped because the linesman had his flag up. Bit of a consultation between the two. Play continues with the kick from nearer the 18-yard line. Referee inviting them to get on with it. Seemed a totally unnecessary stoppage, that. Armstrong. Wilkins. Armstrong. Slightly unorthodox, and indeed, in the end, a use of the hand. Lee. Everything left of him. Headed early. Too high for Walsh. He got up well. But too high to direct the header of Barr. Gregory. And offside given against Woodcock. Space for Lee, which Thomas endeavours to cut down. Duxbury. Lee's still on the touchline. Wilkins rather telegraphed his intent. Hughes. Thomas. Hughes. Busy Thomas. Martin did well. Both James and Alan Davis were prepared to move on to that. That's a loose one, which goes straight to Hughes. Rather took his time. Gordon Davis's first touch wasn't great either. And Wales making nothing of that opportunity. Kennedy. Walsh. Play it back quite often. Kennedy. Just one for Woodcock to fight for. Phillips. Alan Davis. Hopkins. That worked up a few. Kennedy. Wilkins. Kennedy. Hancock being asked to chase some fairly hopeless balls, just not long forward for him. There is no cohesion about the England team at the moment. Bobby Robson's team, and his expression believing it, looking very much just a collection of individuals thrown on the park, which is what they are. And through no fault of either theirs or his. Phillips lost himself for a moment. Walsh hit Ratcliffe. Got away, mainly because of a mistake by Phillips. Wright and Martin both into the six-yard area. Walsh. Wilkins. Gregory far post to come in, two in the middle, here's Mark Wright. Ratcliffe very quickly at him, somewhat awkwardly. Digging out by Hopkins. It's not the tidiest defence you've ever seen, but in the end it's effective. Half an hour gone. One goal of the match scored by Hughes for Wales. Shot from Woodcock, which went wide of the near post as we look. I can't remember England actually creating a chance. Hughes. The referee wants words with Lee. There were one or two rather late challenges going on, and in the end, the referee was forced to give a free kick in the Welsh favour. Tried to play the advantage, but in the end, got a little bit too sticky. Thomas indicating where it should go. Hughes has come wider for the run in. Rush makes the first move. Hughes in behind him. Duxbury with the header. Alan Davis. Jones. Thomas, a bit of a dive in by Duxbury. He's a little prone to do that, it seems to me. Didn't need to make the challenge there at all, and has conceded the free kick. Reminiscent of last week, although not such a crucial moment of the match. Gregory. James. Lee. Duxbury. Two challenges for which the referee could have given a free kick. He chose the first. Cox certainly felt the second more. He was challenged by Ratcliffe. Joey Jones. And Thomas accidentally walking into the ball, knocks it away. Wilkins to take. Martin is the furthest away to the left. The other way is Woodcock. Blocked by Joey Jones at the expense of a corner. David Armstrong. Four players in the six-yard area. On by Martin. Out by Jerry Jones, who's having a fine game for Wales. Hughes. Thomas. Gordon Davison made the run down the middle and stopped because he feared being offside. I'm not sure he would have been. Ends only in a throw, but certainly Wales made ground rather more quickly than England have done. Rush, Kennedy. This time not followed by Wright. It's a corner. Wales takes a position just outside the six-yard area. Jones, as usual, on the near post. Rush with his hands on his hips, number nine. Five is Hopkins of Fulham. Gordon Davis pulls Kennedy away and then goes back. Jerry Jones beaten to it by Martin. Phillips. Hughes going right to left across the box. Duxbury's header. Rush was very quickly in. Comes to Walsh. Minutes of the half remaining, Wales leading by a goal to nothing. I wonder whether the England management will remember that Wales scored first in the meeting last season. Played on a very different pitch, icy at Wembley. England recovered to win 2-1. Kennedy, this is club colleague Phil Neal, who scored the decisive goal from the penalty spot. Bit of pushing on Woodcock. Gregory and Wright forward. And here's Gregory. And it was a clean enough header in that he met it right on the forehead. But he failed to make Neville Southall adjust his position or make any sort of save. Alan Davis did well. And the referee wants to talk to Gregory. Well, with great respect to Mr. Syme, I think he's reading something into that that wasn't there. Gregory was committed. And in the end caught his man because his man was able to pull the ball down. And Gregory didn't expect to be able to do so. Ratcliffe. Jones and Lee. Davis. Thomas. Oh yes. Right covering. He's a good influence off the field and on. Lively lad, to put it mildly. Right. Hughes won it well in the tackle, and this is Rush. Oh dear, what an awful ball from Ian Rush. But Davis came back to collect. Wilkins. And he gets good applause, Ray Wilkins. And it's not an area of the field that I'm sure England supporters would like to see him in too often. It's indicative of how the game is going. And his presence is sadly needed as a creator. A great deal further forward. Here's Gregory. Armstrong. Ratcliffe. Thomas again. Robbie James. Hughes has made a good run again, and a good challenge by Duxbury. He's playing with some confidence, confirming the impression he left last week in Turin when he was marked by one of the best markers in the world and played well. Hughes. Thomas. Hughes and Rush to his left. Oh, Thomas gets a lucky ricochet. Doesn't find the accuracy. And he's a busy player who sparks things. He didn't trouble Peter Shilton then. And the free kick against Tony Woodcock. Showing signs of frustration, and one cannot blame him. Five minutes away from half-time and a great deal of sorting out for Bobby Robson to do. Free kick. And his expression rather sums up how he must be feeling. Hopkins. The Welsh, perhaps, though, will feel a little unhappy with themselves that they're not more than one goal ahead. They've certainly been the better team in the half. And again, pushing. It's a staccato match, though. I think it given against Hughes, he was the pusher. Yeah, just nothing coming off. Robin Martin's intent was to get Armstrong clear on the left, but he struck it a little bit too strongly and the ball running away from Armstrong's run. Gregory, Ratcliffe. And Neville Southall is no more than just the collector. Lee. Oh, Wilkins has made a good forward run then. The ball went backwards. And it does so again, to the point where Shilton has got to come well out of his goal. Hopkins. And just for half a second then, Woodcock seemed to get behind him. But the free kick given against the Arsenal player. Armstrong. Armstrong. Chase for Rush. Wright will be there first. And the ball, in fact, beating them both. Ian Rush, who hasn't quite shown his Liverpool form. He's been in a Welsh shirt. 7 goals in the last 11 matches. He's only scored 1 in the last 6, and he hasn't scored for the last 3. So that completes his recent statistical history. Thomas, Davis,
Jones galloping forward again. Look at that for determination, but he can't make it. Some characters in this side. Jones and Thomas on this left side particularly. John Neal had the sense to get them together at Chelsea. Thomas. Well, that worked. Not quite as intended, but never mind. There's a handball then for a moment. But in the end, it's a free kick to England. Gregory. It has to be said, really, an awful half for England. It looked like a collection of players who are strangers to each other playing in the white shirts of England. Wales, though, leading by a goal to nothing and deserving it, the goal scorer, number 11, going off there, scoring on his debut, Mark Hughes. For the record, the scorer of the only goal of the match so far is the 14th Hughes to play for Wales. And surprisingly, there have been only four Phillips, of whom Leighton Phillips was much the most successful. Here's one of the Davises. Phillips giving an early touch of the ball. To Neville Southall. Didn't see too much of it to worry him in the first half. Lee. Phillips. Rush. Free kick against the Welshman. He was not too impressed with the decision. It's just a messy challenge, really, by both players. Supporters who've travelled across the border doing their best to lift England. Hughes, Jones, Rush, that's a good flick. That's Shilton there before Thomas. He very nearly got the little ball through, did he, in Rush? It's Kennedy. But nobody was moving on. They were all coming towards the ball then, the three England players, who were possible recipients of the ball. Hopkins. good jump. Nobody feeding on it. Rush, right, Kennedy. Marshall pushed up and Kennedy did well, holding it well. He could play it through now, though. Jerry Jones covering Sammy Lee. Right, not cleanly, Thomas. That's better. Not only to James, Kennedy. Push on Woodcock. Players forward, all rather static. Hopkins. Off the referee, which helped the Welsh. Rush. James. A little bit lucky with the bounce of the ball. His luck was bound to run out. His mind what he was going to do with it. Right, Kennedy. Hopkins. Ratcliffe. Thomas, right. And he was fouled as he struggled to keep possession. And surprisingly, his club colleague, David Armstrong, offered him nothing to write in terms of a pass. Wilkins. Woodcock. More seemingly unsure whether to go forward or not. Armstrong. Does now, and is offside. Well, there's more noise for England, which is a bit surprising. Probably the right decision, but the application letting David Phillips down. Wright is the first of the two big men from the back to come forward, but Martin close behind and goes further into the goal. Walsh on the near post, Martin behind him. Ian Wright changed places. Good header away by Jones. Pressure came from Gregory. And off the top of the crossbar. And amazingly out again. Thomas who cleared. And the free kick against Robbie James. And the first time we've seen the Welsh under pressure. Well, two escapes for Wales. Well, certainly Southall saved first of all by his crossbar, and then as the ball came back across again, it was Thomas who dug it away on a line with the far post as we look. Walsh again coming on the near post. Wilkins and Armstrong. And Wilkins takes it. And Martin, who came in with great determination but wasn't successful. An England corner. And this, by some distance, is their best spell. Bit of curl on it. Came off Hopkins. Maybe the fact that England have got a substitute warming up has inspired one or two. Armstrong again. And the goalkeeper nowhere! And the ball straight across the six-yard box. And Ratcliffe made no decision then to go for it, and neither did Neville Southall. Quite extraordinary. And here's the substitute, Luther Blissett. Yes, there seems to be a greater determination about England in the second period. We've had 10 minutes. And in most of those 10 minutes, they've been on top. It's Gregory. And Gregory indicating he's going to try for a long throw. And Alvin Martin making his way forward. Mark Hughes coming with him. The ball held in the crowd until attacker and defender get in position. Won by Lee, but away by Jones. Clearance, in fact, blocked by Lee. Walsh. Lee. Woodcock's flick. James with time to let the ball run a bit. Martin and Hughes. Referee played on, but Hughes let Martin know he was there. Referee had a quick word about Welsh aggression. Hopkins. And the Welsh looking surprisingly rattled. Kennedy. Oh, that's useful. He was looking to finish it. It didn't work out for him. But at least it was of Liverpool style. Showing confidence to have a go at people. In the crowd. It will come back just as the new one comes on. It's David Armstrong back in the England side for the first time since being substituted against West Germany, and that was back in October 1982. 16 goals he scored this season. Wilkins, Armstrong, Walsh. James. Mike Hughes finding himself trying to go two ways at once. Woodcock. Gregory. Martin, Armstrong. Battling for the ball very much more successfully. And an offside decision given. Vince Rush. Duxbury. Martin. Walsh looks much happier when he's allowed to come back and collect the ball like that. This is Duxbury. Useful run by the fullback. Following the example set by Kennedy. Doesn't score as many goals as Kennedy. His last one was back in December 82. Phillips. Rush. Finds Gordon Davis. Thomas. Well, there's nobody wide, he goes there himself. Thomas, his 42nd cap. Back on the ground where he started. Days of John Neal and Alvin Griffiths. Wilkins. Phillips. Right, Gregory, Walsh, seems to have made up his mind or been told to play his more natural game, running where he wants to in search of the ball, rather than waiting forward, wondering when to go. Hughes. Alan Davis, Thomas, looking for the challenge, but the free kick has been given for the earlier one. In which Alan Davis is a bit disappointed. Five Welshmen in a line along the 18-yard line. One on the near side is Davis. Free kick much too short. Hopkins. Woodcock so keen. Comes to Thomas. Gets away from Lee. Oh, well played by Shilton. Didn't quite go, I think, where he intended, but the hand was desperately needed. And Thomas getting away from both Lee and Duxbury with a really teasing cross, curling away from the goalkeeper to the far post. And Peter Shilton just able to get a palm to it. Rush couldn't get to it. Wilkins. Gregory. Oh, dear, oh, dear. Rush. Free kick given. Twenty-five minutes left. Wales still leading by a goal. They scored in the 17th minute. Met by Martin. Davis. Still gets through to Hughes. Davis. Now a chance for a break. And well played by Thomas. Ferreting away. Woodcock. Duxbury. Wilkins loses out the rush eventually after the spade work had been done by Joey Jones. There has been absolutely no guile from the England midfield at all. Here's Walsh. And the judge to have tried to turn Hopkins or push and pull him. James. Woodcock. Duxbury. Useful from Lee to Woodcock. The pace of Ratcliffe. It was Phillips who got the ball, but Ratcliffe was very, very quickly at him. Kennedy. Walsh in the line. Kennedy once again using that to run at them. And he's done more with a couple of runs from fullback, even if they weren't successful in the end. And we've seen from a player from midfield, you're supposed to do that sort of thing. Martin. Wilkins. Lee pulls wide to the right again. Walsh. It's a bit strong. Gregory. Thomas. Certainly contender for the man of the match. Hughes and Martin. Marsh goes to the middle. Wilkins, Armstrong, Woodcock to the right, once again the Welsh pushing forward, and then having to be careful about the offside. The final ball, a disappointment. Tony Woodcock scored against Northern Ireland in England's last international match. Advantage of errors to do so. This is 12th for his country. Not the best moment for the two England central defenders. And the free kick given. Alan Davis, everything left of him in a Welsh shirt. Bit tight. James Square, bit short for Phillips. Gordon Davis, James, Alan Davis. It's intended for Jones, but he just got underneath it. Phillips. Rush. Change of pace. Wilkins, the back man for England. Hopkins. Last season, England have only three survivors on the field, as Wales have seven. There has been the nucleus of the side all the way through. Cameron Rush has been a very important part. And six Welsh players have played in all six matches this season. Phillips. Rush, intended for Gordon Davis. Here's Alan Kennedy again. Sammy Lee. Woodcock this way. Well up by Phillips. Robbie James. And apart from that fairly frenetic spell, early into the half, England have really not bothered Wales at all. Liverpool player on Liverpool player, the free kick against Rush. But I think both will be feeling that quality is rather different from what they're used to playing for their club. Wilkins, Hopkins, Gregory. Been too many England players who have not done themselves justice at all. Walsh, Kennedy, Wilkins pulls square, but Didn't inform anybody. Here's Walsh. And still. Oh, he's a bit unlucky to get nothing out of it. Came back off his shins. No doubt the referee was right. Thomas. Woodcock. Handball. Wilkins inviting Alan Kennedy to come over. 15 minutes left. Four players are moved into the box, now five with Alvin Martin. In the end, Armstrong takes it. Hopkins header. James. Wilkins. Lee. Walsh there for the fullback, and Thomas for the excellent challenge. Lee hasn't been able to get away on that right side, and it's a lot to do with this little fella. Strong. Hit Jones rather than vice versa. Hughes. Just a bit too far ahead, I think. Duxbury there first. Lee Jones looking for just that. Here's Gordon Davis. Just a question of picking it right, and he picked it totally wrong. Did it bubble a little bit before he hit it? I don't know. But he certainly set himself. Waited for Shilton to come forward. Took his time and then got underneath it. On comes Luther Blissett. He's been out of the squad since going to play in Italy for AC Milan. And then they're deciding they will have a front line of three. Here's Gordon Davis. Martin. Not easy. Oh! And he was very, very lucky to escape. And a bit of cheek from Mark Hughes was so nearly successful. Alvin Martin struggling to get the ball under control. They get a back pass to Peter Shilton. And I think you'll find it's the foot of Hughes which gets in. Yes, it does indeed. And it was wide of the far post, thankfully for England. Got a knock in all that. It's not been an easy return for him. and then which England player can be entirely happy with his performance this evening. So we could have another substitution. That's Terry Fenwick taking the outer tracksuit off. And that would be another new cap. Rush. Lee. Queen's Park Rangers captain. Martin still hobbling a bit. Woodcock. Useful, and Southall saw it very early indeed. Walsh, Blissett and Woodcock in the middle, Gregory pulling over to the far post. Phillips shut the door. 10 minutes left, up comes Wright for the corner. England want to make their substitution. And Terry Fenwick becomes the 21st new cap in Bobby Robson's reign. Martin has hobbled off to the dressing room. Not cleanly by Davis, but then by James. Duxbury. Walsh holding England just outside the centre circle. Wright. Not the best challenge of the night from Robbie James. Wilkins. Duxbury going forward. To be said, the pass was a negative one. Rush. James. Cut out by Kennedy. Gave it to Rush, and here's Davis. Gordon Davis, another opportunity for him. Well, he struck it more cleanly, but he struck it wide. It was a better attempt than the earlier one. He's only scored one for his country and took a long time to get that one. He got the opportunity, courtesy of Rush. Challenge from Wright wasn't one of his best. And he hit that one much more cleanly, but wide. Here's Thomas. Gregory. No one to pick it up. There's a no man's land between those defending and the three waiting up front. He's one of the three. Joey Jones there first. The weekend, rather. Thomas. Wilkins. Lee, Woodcock, Alan Davis, offside against Mark Hughes. Referee allows play to continue. Hughes. And did he manage to take that? Kennedy. Phillips. Hughes. Gordon Davies in a lot of space. Phillips up in the box. Five Welshmen there. Duxbury, header across the goal. And Phillips not being able to get hold of the ball. Jones, often he seems to have been there first. Rush. Good foot in by Wright. But here's Rush again, surely. Flag stayed down, he seemed to slightly stand on the ball, right on the penalty spot. Five minutes left of the last match between Wales and England in the British Championship. Could hardly be said that the series has come to an end with great style. But it looks as though it's coming to an end with a Welsh victory. Alan Davis. Wilkins. Woodcock. And the free kick's been given. Four minutes left. Six England players in the area. Away by Joey Jones. Kennedy. Walsh. Alan Davis. Duxbury should cover that, and does. Rush. Wilkins. Woodcock, strong challenge by Thomas, but a perfectly fair one. Here's Hughes. Wilkins. Woodcock chasing to the end. Good Welsh voices to mark the finish. Kennedy. Lee to the right. Robbie James. Rush this side. Push and run with Wright. And cleanly away, although Wright able to cut down the area once he'd gone past. Came back to him. Robbie James, he got in the cross. Off the chest of Ray Wilkins. England not in trouble yet. Phillips. And it won't count because handball's been given against Gordon Davis. It was Rush who put the ball in the net. And he really thumped it in too. But as Davis had the ball, he used his forearm. And the referee whistled, in fact, before Hughes struck. Davis. Well, the Welsh will reckon they could have won by more, and they could indeed. Here's Hughes, and here's Rush. Mm, he struck that well, but straight at Shilton. Lissett looking for the early one. But no room for manoeuvre. And the Scottish referee is just playing the final seconds for stoppages for the meetings between Wales and England in the home international series come to an end. Mark Wright, Wilkins, working them for a second on his feet. Davis, Rush, didn't quite get it right, and Wright did. Wilkins. Gregory. Kennedy. Good header by Hopkins. Thomas. Oh, dear. Well, that's something that Blissett would seem to have brought back from Italy with him. That was worthy of Gentile, that. Phillips to take. Goal kick. The referee looks at both linesmen who have already given him a signal. In fact, a free kick has been given. And a great deal of applause greets a Welsh victory. The goal scored by Mark Hughes on his debut. And it's Welshman who will look back on the end of this series, particularly Mike England, their manager, with satisfaction. And all that one can say about England, they will be happy to forget tonight. And one can only hope that Bobby Robson will be able to get the squad together that he wants for the matches against Scotland and against the Soviet Union and on tour in South America, because he has a lot of work to do to fashion an English challenge to qualify for the next World Cup. The final result of the final home international between Wales and England. Wales 1, the goal scorer Hughes. England 0. Mike, from the Welsh point of view, a very satisfactory end to the series.
Yes, it was quite a magnificent performance from our point of view. I was absolutely delighted with the way the team played, their total commitment, the way they gave everything that they'd got, and I think they thoroughly deserved to win.
And you must feel that you've found a player in Mark Hughes.
Yeah, most certainly. Ian Rush, you know, has needed someone to give him that support, and I think tonight we saw that Mark Hughes has a tremendous future. He gives defenders problems, and he and Rush, I think, are going to be a very, very exciting combination.
He's physically strong, isn't he? And that counts for a bit.
Over the last 12 months, that's what's happened. You know, he's only 19, and I think he's developed now his strength, and he's had these very important games with Manchester United, and I think that also has given him the confidence that is needed. And he scores goals. You know, it's great. We're very excited.
This is a lucky ground for you, isn't it?
Touch wood, I haven't lost here since I've been a manager. That's a very dangerous thing to say. But my very first game 4 years ago was when we beat England 4-1. And since then, we've never lost a game on this ground.
You must want to play a few more here.
Oh, yeah, we love it.